The 10 News Weather Authority, always watching and tracking for you from the JES Weather Center.
Good evening there, everyone. Here is a look at our Roanoke-Blacksburg Regional Airport SkyCam, showing pretty clear skies and pretty calm conditions out there. Now, what it's not showing is the cool temperatures that we're seeing outside. There is a little bit of moisture in the air, so it's feeling a little bit cooler and a little bit chillier than our current temperatures are showing. But nonetheless, you could take about 3 degrees off of these temperatures or so. So you would say Lewisburg is currently sitting at 36, but it most likely feels about 32, 33 degrees out there. Smith Mountain Lake at 40, Lynchburg 41, South Boston 34, and Hillsville and Withville both at 39 degrees at the moment. Now, overnight tonight, we're going to see partly cloudy conditions here and there, but for the most part, we will be mostly clear, and so our temperatures will be able to decline well into the lower 30s for just about everyone. Rocky Mount, Alta Vista, Lynchburg 33, Martinsville 30, waking up tomorrow at about 6, 7 a.m. Blacksburg and Withville also at 32 degrees, the freezing point. Now, our radar isn't picking up anything at the moment, so it's pretty much all in the clear, and we're dealing with clear skies. However, there are a couple clouds out there from time to time. Now, what we're tracking for tomorrow is the potential for partly cloudy skies and then mostly cloudy skies to build in with a couple of showers. We're also tracking the potential for some spotty snow flurries and some pretty cold air that's going to be moving in. And then later on this week, after say Tuesday and Wednesday, we'll be turning mostly sunny and warmer temperatures will build back in. Here's a look at future tracker showing low pressure. It's fairly weak. It's going to be moving through and it's going to be bringing some isolated showers for us tomorrow afternoon and evening. You'll notice there are pieces of purple and pinks in there. That's mixed precipitation. That's also some snow. So let's dive in a little bit closer to that as it also moves in to our Wednesday. Here's a look at what we're tracking tonight. Clear skies, and then Tuesday, mostly cloudy conditions start to build in early on in the morning. By midday, the Highlands and the NRB are seeing mostly cloudy conditions. By 4 p.m., we see our first rainfall. And then by 8 p.m., we're dealing with a little bit of snow in parts of the Highlands, perhaps in Highland and Bath County. Also moving through parts of Lexington over here, the NRB could also see a couple of upper level snowflakes. Now, if these get to the ground or not, it's going to depend on the temperature. Reminder, we got to be about 32 degrees or darn close to it in order for these snowflakes to make it to the ground. Now, by 12 a.m. on Wednesday, we're dealing with mostly cloudy conditions, still seeing some snow out there for the western slopes. So you guys will likely get some accumulation. And then by Wednesday afternoon, we're turning mostly clear. So we're going to have about a 2-day period where we'll have on and off isolated showers and the potential of seeing a few snowflakes and perhaps some accumulation in some areas. Winds will be gusting on Wednesday. They'll turn calm on Thursday and then pick right back up on our Friday, getting to about 10 to 20 miles per hour. Thursday morning is going to be pretty cold, getting down to about 20 degrees in most spots. Friday, we warm up just a hair. So after low pressure moves through, colder air is certainly going to be building in and clear skies on top of that. But on Saturday, we're tracking big time low pressure that's going to be moving through. And on Sunday, we'll likely see some widespread rain across all of our zones. But for the next 2 days, about a 20% chance of rain for the NRB and the Highlands. Same goes for the south side. Thursday starts to clear up for Lynchburg. And then this weekend, we're watching rain and we're tracking rain at about 50% for our Sunday as of now. This could all change as we get closer to that date. But as of now, it's looking like this could be the first sort of shift in our weather pattern where we get that southerly flow and we get some widespread rain, perhaps even some snow flurries on the backside.